बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज़ द ग्रेसफुल ग्रामर हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल डिजिटल टीचिंग प्रोग्राम। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द ग्रेसफुल ग्रामर हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल, आई वेलकम यू टू योर न्यू क्लास। फर्स्ट होमवर्क ऑफ ग्रेड 7, सब्जेक्ट सोशल स्टडीज। टेक आउट योर SST बुक, नो योर वर्ल्ड 7। Front cover of the book has a picture of Earth on it. Author of the book is Khatija Chagla Beg. Your book is divided into 3 sections, that is history, geography and civics. One of the interesting features of this book is Annie's notes. Annie is a time traveler from Lahore. Her brother invented a time traveling machine, and because of that machine she is traveling in history. She has a diary where she is writing down all historical events which she is experiencing by her own eyes. Isn't it interesting? This is the homework which school has provided you. Total 5 questions are given in general. YouTube links are also provided for your proper understanding. How to start your work? Write your name, your father's name and your class on your SST notebook. Put the heading of first term in your notebook. Make a title page of first homework. You have to read and understand the material on your own and answer the questions after thorough reading of respective pages. You are advised to watch the reference video for the proper understanding. Now, question number 1. Imagine you are a soldier in Mahmud's army. Recount what happened during the Battle of Somnath. Write the answer with the help of Annie's notes, page number 11. Before starting your answer, I would like to give you some introduction about Mahmud Ghazni's attack on Somnath. Mahmud Ghazni's attack on Somnath temple made him one of the great heroes of Islam. He was well known as an idol breaker. He attacked Somnath temple where sculpture of Lord Shiva float above the ground. Mahmud Ghazni destroyed the sculpture and revealed that it was floating in air because of magnetic slabs which were hidden in the side walls of temple. Now, more experience or more explanation you can get after reading Annie's note on page number 11, where the whole picture is explained. You have to take the help of page number 11, last 3 paragraphs, and then you have to answer your question. Now, question number 2. What do you know about Battle of Panipat? For answering this question, you have to open page number 31 of your book. On page number 31, Mughal Empire is explained, plus the information about the Battle of Panipat is mentioned there. On that page, you will find Do You Know? In that portion, you will find more details about the Battle of Panipat. The Battle of Panipat was between Babur and Ibrahim Lodi's army. They both were the Mughal emperors. In this battle, the Mughal emperor used the firearm for the first time. I have given you some information, and for further information and for detailed explanation, you have to go through page number 31. After that, you can easily answer this question in your notebook. Now, question number 3. Paste the pictures of some of the products of cottage industries. Now you have to open your book, page number 94, where cottage industries are given. Cottage industries are small industries usually set up in homes. Now you have to read the portion of cottage industries from your book, and there you can easily find the product of some of the cottage industries. You have to write the names of those products and paste the picture of that product. Now question number 4. Make a timeline of Muslims' arrival in the subcontinent. To answer this question, you have to open page number 2 and 3 of your book. In your notebook, you have to draw the timeline of arrivals of Muslim ruler in the subcontinent. In the book, the timeline is given. You can decorate and make it very neat with the help of colors. The timeline starts from Muhammad bin Qasim and it ends with Aurangzeb Alamgir. Now from the book, go through the timeline. You will see that how the different Muslim conqueror ruled with the passage of time. Draw this timeline and repeat and revise it thoroughly. Now question number 5. This is the last question of your first homework. Draw and write about spring tide and neem tide. Before you answer this question, I want you to tell you something about tides. Tides are the rise and fall of sea levels caused by the combined effect of the gravitational forces exerted by the moon and the sun and the rotation of the earth. So this is actually tides. There are two types of tides, neap tides and spring tides. Now you have to open your book, page number 55. On page number 55, you will find out do you know portion. In that portion, the book has explained very well that what is the difference between neap tide and spring tide. The diagram is also mentioned. So I want you to go through that do you know portion and answer the question in the notebook. Thank you for watching. I hope you will complete this homework till the deadline. Submit it for checking. After this first homework, second homework will be issued. You can come to school for any guidance from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. There will be an assessment from these homework. So I want you to do it with your heart and repeat and revise it. One thing I want to mention that before starting your homework in the copy, you have to give the heading of first term in your notebook. Keep studying with us, to which height we cannot rise. Allah Hafiz.